Yeah, well, we don't want to make it too hard to find, do we?
What do you know? Evelyn Randall.
Yeah. That'll save us asking a lot of questions or waiting for her to tell us her boring life story, huh?
Now, you know that an inmate's file is private and confidential.
Yeah. What's it say, huh?
You laughs last, eh?
Cheer up, Dor. You ought to be glad you got one of them Snoopy reporters.
I just don't feel so good.
What's wrong with you, love? You look a bit flushed. She's burning up.
You mean she's not faking? Uh-huh. What is uh-huh supposed to mean?
I forgot to tell you. You know that poor little mate who got her nose broken, the one that I told off? Well, a bloke from the health department came here looking for her. He reckons somebody on her plane had one of them foreign diseases.
Now, what's that got to do with Doreen?
Well, Jenny could have passed it on to Dor. Dor could have one of them funny diseases.
She was nowhere near Doreen. Don't talk flaming rot.
Yeah, but you know how them bugs get around.
Yeah, and I've got Evelyn to fix me up something, but it doesn't seem to be doing much good.
Well, you didn't take it, did you?
Yeah.
You flaming little idiot. Do you know what she's in for? Manslaughter. She gave one of her patients one of the home brews she makes up, and the patient kicked the bucket. She's nothing but a bloody poisoner.
One minute we're getting on real well with her, next she tries a swifty like this.
Yeah, well, I've read about them poisons, and there's nothing you can do.
Now, you listen to me. Evelyn's a herbalist. If she's given you the wrong stuff, she'll know the antidote.
If she wanted to poison Dor, she's not going to tell.
Want a bet?
What the hell have you done, Doreen?
What?
You gave her one of your crackpot medicines, didn't you?
Well, a herbal mixture. She said she wasn't feeling well.
Well, she's bloody worse now.
Oh, no, she couldn't be.
She's as sick as a dog. And if you don't tell me what was in it, you are going to need a doctor yourself.
What have you been giving her, you bloody quack?
I don't understand it.
How sick is she?
Now, did you take this mixture just as I told you? You can't have.
What was in it?
Oh, just castor oil beans. They're quite harmless as long as they're taken as directed. Now, where's the rest of it?
In the jug.
Oh, what's it doing in there?
Well, I warmed it up. It tasted better.
You stupid little fool.
Now, wait a minute. What difference does it make whether it was hot or cold?
The beans become toxic when they're cooked. No wonder she's sick.
I'm gonna die.
Why didn't you follow my instructions?
How was she supposed to know it was going to do her harm if she cooked her?
I told her what to do if she can't understand plain
Listen,
English.
Instead of bitching about this, what are we going to do here?
Well, the chickweed's antidote. I'll prepare an infusion.
Oh, no, you won't. She's going to the infirmary. Get her down there, Judy. There she can get some proper treatment.
Will she get proper treatment?
Shut up! Let's see if we can get her down there. Love, are you okay?
Me, not me, love.
Are you crazy? You're in here for killing someone with your jungle juice and you go and try it on Doreen.
It is not jungle juice. And I did not kill that woman. It was her own fault she died.
Well, tell that to the judge.
The woman was a fool. I was treating her for skin cancer.
Oh, you got a cure for that too, have you?
Look, I gave her specific instructions to apply the preparation to her skin. She thought it would do her better if she drank it. I am sorry she died. It was not my fault.
Oh, well, as long as you're sorry, I suppose that's okay.
Look, I'm in here for manslaughter. A doctor in my position wouldn't even have been charged.
If anything happens to Doreen...
Nothing will happen to her. I'm sure your orthodox medicine will fix her up.
Well, you had better be right. And if I ever catch you performing any of your quackery in here again,
Don't you threaten me.
Well, it's given most of us a break. I mean, look at me, sitting at a desk like a little kid, saying, yes, sir, no, sir, three bags full, sir.
And I wish you could come out with me, and then you could give me a hand.
What's that?
Shh, don't let on to be. This is the list that Evie gave me, you know, about the herbs. But I wouldn't know a belladonna from a bull's foot.
Oh, don't worry about that. Sid will be able to tell you what's what.
Yeah. God, Dor, is that clever.
He's given you a real interest in life, hasn't he? Mm. Don't forget to say hello to him for me.
Oh, wish you had someone, Dor.
I'm okay, Izzy.
I got your stuff.
hope we got it right.
Oh, marvellous, Lizzie. Now, let's see. Spurt, yes. Foxglove. Comfrey root. And what's this?
Oh, that's a pollen stuff.
Pandanus palm.
I don't know the name of it. But I hope it is the right stuff.
It is. Oh, thank you for getting it for me, Lizzie.
Oh, I should be thanking you. It was a real tonic to old Sid. I told him I was helping you, see? It was just like a kid playing with a new toy.
And the officer didn't suspect what you were up to?
Oh, Noxie! No way. He kept rattling on about his interest in plants and pointing stuff out to her, giving them their battalion names, keeping her talking while I collected it. Hey, what's this mug?
Oh, that's bread mould. Oh. Judy got that for me.
What's it for?
Well, it's to grow cultures. I only hope it'll be warm enough in here.
But it'd be better off in the laundry. It's always hot and steamy in there.
Oh, yes, I thought of that, but you know how Bee feels. She sees those dishes in the laundry, she might throw them out.
Oh, I could put them in there for you.
Could you?
No worries. Bee would never know.
Oh, you are a great help, Lizzie.
Better be going. I'll get those things from you in the morning. All right?
Yes, fine. Good night.
Good night.
First thing I'm getting rid of.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. It's time to get up.
I'm crook.
Save it for the screws.
Honest. I've been awake half the night with pains.
It's not your ticker, is it?
No. It's my stomach.
You haven't taken one of Evelyn's home brews, have you?
No.
Well, you don't just wake up in the morning sick for nothing. It must be something you ate or drank.
All I had was me meals. Oh, I suppose I better get up.
Well, if you're that crook, maybe you better stay in bed and we'll tell the screws.
Oh, I'll be all right if I just take it easy.
Well, you better report for morning sick call.
Yeah. A drop of medicinal brandy might do me good.
Well, you can't be that seedy if you're still thinking about booze.
No. When you get old, you get all sorts of things. I'll be as right as rain soon.
Waking up alone.